Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Matt Williams. I'm a tutor in politics and what is known as the Access Fellow here at Jesus College at the University of Oxford, and I'm delighted to be here with Shorief. So do you mind telling us a bit about yourself?
Yeah, hi everyone, I'm Shorief Ali, second year medic here at Jesus. I'm also the Access and Outreach Officer for MedSoc.
So Shorief, I always like to start interviews by asking people, can you describe Oxford with any three words? What would you choose?
Definitely, it's got a lot of history. Mm-hmm. I've already broken the word count there. But history, opulence, mm-hmm. and marvel.
Oh, nice. Okay. And medicine. So that is a relatively unusual example of a degree which is quite similar mm-hmm. across different universities, mm-hmm. right? Because at the end of it, you've got to become a doctor, yeah. you can work in the NHS. And so the type of qualification you would get out of, say, the University of Southampton is not going to be wildly different to Oxford, right? Mm-hmm. So, therefore, why Oxford?
Why Oxford? Well, that's a really great question. I think the course structure in Oxford really lends itself to helping you be an independent thinker and not have to regurgitate facts, as I would say most of medicine is taught, especially me now going into my third year, my FHS year, or in other universities, intercalation, where I get to choose a project of my own choosing and I get to pursue topics within the biomedical field that really interest me. And so that's something that really drew me to Oxford.
Right, because Oxford is a centre of research excellence. I mean, exactly. all medical schools are, but you're going to be working on something pretty cool, is that yeah. right? Do you mind just describing a bit?
Yeah, of course. I'm working in the Department of Pharmacology and I'm helping my supervisor develop a drug to treat catecholaminergic polymorphic ventricular tachycardia. It's a real mouthful, CPVT, and we're targeting rhamnodine receptor 1s in the heart, so it's very interesting.
And this is mostly for children, you were explaining?
Yeah, it's mainly a disease that primarily affects children, and so there's not much medications out there that help children with this disease, and so, you know, it's great to be able to be a part of something that
right. That's people's lives. Pretty awesome as a third year undergrad to be doing that.
Yeah, I know. There's such a range, such a breadth of cool science that's going on. As you said, it's a centre of research excellence here in Oxford. And the fact that you get to access this with, you know, I have very little background in research and this is probably my first official research assignment, and that I'm able to do something so cool and so groundbreaking it's really exciting.
At some university medical schools, you work with patients mm. earlier on, right? Yeah. Whereas at Oxford, the clinical side of things is after your first 3 years, mm-hmm. is that right? So why would you choose that approach of not seeing patients until a little bit?
Yeah, I think, and it took a bit of convincing for myself as well, because I always liked the patient-facing side of medicine. Mm. But you really have to subscribe fully to the Oxford course and the way they do things here. It's all about building those scientific foundations that I think put us in good stead for when we do face patients eventually. Right. The fact that we're able to work it out from first principles, and not only does that help us develop a suitable treatment plan for the patient, but it also helps them understand it a bit better.
Okay, fantastic. Now, that approach of having 3 year medical sciences and then a more clinical focused mm. approach to medicine is quite similar at Cambridge, yeah. right? So I asked you why Oxford, why not Cambridge?
That's a funny question, because I actually applied to Cambridge first and got rejected.
Oh, me too.
Yeah. Well, I took a gap year and reapplied to Oxford.
Right.
But I think, like you said, there's not much really setting them apart in terms of course structure, because they're both are very traditional medical courses, both have a very similar format. But what drew me to Oxford was actually Jesus College itself.
Okay.
And, you know, the community here and the Welsh feel. Because I'm originally from Wales.
Oh, right, nice. So the Welsh field, just for viewers, so this college, Jesus College, was founded originally for Welsh students mm-hmm. only. Nowadays we have students from all over the world, but yeah. you're right, we still proudly cling to that Welsh heritage. So yeah, that's really cool. What do you think has surprised you most about Oxford since you've been here?
What surprised me most about Oxford? Well, actually, you touched on it when you were talking about how there's medical students across the UK that are probably, you know, doing very similar things all in the same year, etc. But I think being a medical student in Oxford, you don't feel like a medical student. You don't feel that separation that I think my friends who are medical students in other universities feel. I think there's a really integrated approach. A lot of my friends aren't medics. I do have medic friends, but a lot of them are from humanities, languages. So I think what I really appreciate is that I have such a breadth of friendships and people I can speak to from different subjects.
So, and as someone who's applied to medical school twice, what top tips would you give someone who's starting on that journey, yeah. how they can perform at their best?
Yeah, I think at first it's quite demoralizing. I think you have to really feel comfortable in getting rejected. It's, I think, if you can bounce back from rejection and come back stronger. I think that's probably the biggest and most important quality. Not only does that help you as a medical student, but it'll help you in all walks of life and into your professional career.
Well, isn't that the truth? I'm afraid, yeah, rejection is a bad one, but not necessarily even a bad one. It's just something you just have to...
They always say rejection is redirection, right?
Nice, absolutely. And for Oxford, we use the UCAT test, which is used by a bunch of medical schools, right? Any tips on that?
Well, quite a tough test. I was quite lucky, and I say I'm quite lucky, because I was able to sit the BMAT to get into Oxford.
Just before
they changed. And so the UCAT really appeal to my skill set. The BMAT was a lot more like it's more suited to me.
Right.
But I obviously had to sit the UCAT. So tips I would give, give yourself enough time. I think I remember giving myself 6 to 8 weeks to prepare for the UCAT and just practice.
And the interview, so at Oxford we don't have sort of short form MMI style interviews, they're longer, more academic. Any advice on those?
Yeah, I mean, I'll give the run of the mill, and that is, be prepared to be wrong. I think they're always trying to work out your thinking process. And don't be afraid to show a bit of your personality as well, especially for medicine. They're not looking for academic robots. They are looking for someone who has the academic credentials, but also the soft skills that you'll need as a doctor. So don't be afraid to let your personality shine through in the interview.
Nice, yeah, really good advice. Could you tell us something you don't like about Oxford?
What I don't like about Oxford, I think sometimes the prestige and, you know, Oxford continuously does well in the league tables can sometimes make us rest on our laurels a bit.
Okay.
We can become a bit complacent and maybe not so receptive to feedback that I think, because I'm the second year JCC rep for medicine as well, and sometimes I do feel that it can be a bit more of an open ear, per se.
Okay. Fair enough. And what do you do when you're not a medical student? What do you like?
Yeah, I'm currently preparing for Summer 8 for the Jesus College Book Club. That takes up a lot of my time at the moment, and I also like to play badminton, so I'm also the captain of the Jesus Badminton team. We've just resurrected that this year. Just socialising, going out with friends.
Right, so just to explain, Summer 8 is bumps racing, right? So you have to row into people.
Exactly.
Right? Was rowing something you'd done before you came to Oxford?
No, it's not. It's one of those things that, especially from my background, I always thought was something that I wouldn't be able to access. But Oxford, especially Jesus, has made rowing really accessible to me. And I started as a complete novice, and I've worked my way up onto the boat. So yeah, it's great.
Nice, and because of our Welsh heritage, we will say bleed green to our rowers.
So
bleed green for the Summer 8.
Yeah.
Well, brilliant. It's lovely to chat with you, Shorief, and all the best with your research.
Yeah,
and
thank you.
With Summer 8. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. Bye.